The IFM 209 study is a prospective randomized multicenter trial which aims to compare the standard strategy with transplant to a strategy based on RVD alone without transplant. And the second interim analysis was previously presented 5 years ago by Michel Attal. And today we present the result with an extended follow-up. So 700 patients were randomized after stratification on ISS and FISH between two arms. Arm A, RVD alone with 8 cycles of RVD, and the standard arm, the control arm, arm B with transplant, 3 cycles RVD in induction, high dose melphalan with autologous stem cell transplantation, 2 courses of RVD in consolidation, and in the both arms, there was a lenalidomide maintenance for 1 year. The primary endpoint was PFS, and secondary endpoints, overall response rate, MRD, time to progression, overall survival, and toxicity. The patient characteristics were well balanced between the two arms, with a median age at about 59 years, and about 18% of the patients have high-risk disease, ISS3 and cytogenetic, high-risk cytogenetics defined by translocation 414, translocation 1415, and deletion 17P. So with an extended follow-up at near 90 months, the updated PFS is still met, and the primary objective is still met with a median PFS at 47 months in the transplant arm, and it is significantly superior to the RVD alone arm with a median PFS at 35 months. The hazard ratio is 0.7. That means that transplant is associated with a 30% reduction in the risk of progression or death. For patients who relapse, the most frequent regimen used is a pomalidomide-based regimen, about 40% of the patient in both arms. And in the RVD alone arm, about 75% of the patients receive a transplant at relapse. Few patients received daratumumab or carfilzomib. It was mostly pomalidomide and chemotherapy like DCEP or bendamustine who have been used. Thanks to the efficacy of the salvage treatment, PFS2 are similar in both arms, and there isn't any differences in overall survival too. Interestingly, the 8 years overall survival is more than 60% in the two arms after 8 years of follow-up. When we look at the subgroup analysis, the transplant benefit to all patient subcategories, especially in ISS3 patients and in high-risk cytogenetic patients. The MRD negativity rate is increased in the transplant group at about 30% compared with 20% for RVD alone group. And transplant is superior to VRD alone, even in patients who achieve an undetectable MRD at 10-6. Regarding the tolerability, there isn't any differences in global health-related quality of life and functional scores, neither in terms of incidence of the SPM, second primary malignancy. This incidence is about 7-8% in both groups, with myelodysplastic syndromes and acute myeloid leukemia in less than 2% of the patients. To conclude, also there isn't any difference in PFS2 and overall survival. Frontline transplant remains our first choice for newly diagnosed multiple myeloma, with a view to cure myeloma in as many patients as possible, since 35% of the patients in transplant arm didn't relapse after 8 years of follow-up. Nevertheless, to delay transplant in first relapse could be an option in exceptional circumstances, like the current COVID-19 pandemic.